Hello friends, welcome back to another episode by Engineering Today, and hope you're all having a great time. We have some exciting updates to share regarding the recent developments at Starbase facility. On August 2nd, the booster transport stand stabilization pins underwent testing, a crucial step in ensuring the stability and safety of transport equipment. Meanwhile, the top hat can crusher component has been meticulously placed onto the hot stage test article, marking a significant milestone in the testing process. This assembly is an essential part of the ongoing efforts to improve and validate SpaceX technologies. Another noteworthy event is the S-30 Common Dome's successful journey into the High Bay area, signifying progress in operations. The workers are continuously striving to improve efficiency and streamline their process to make significant advancements. However, it's important to mention that on a recent commute to Starbase, Highway 4 had to be closed due to a substantial wreck, causing substantial traffic delays. Many of us experienced the inconvenience of being stuck in traffic for over an hour before the Department of Transportation, DOT, representative informed everyone that it might take another 4 to 5 hours before traffic could resume. This incident may explain why the LC area has been relatively quiet lately. On a more positive note, the OLM has been cleared of scaffolding, which is great progress towards SpaceX objectives. It signifies that they're making steady headway in their preparations. As we head towards the next round of testing, it's worth noting that the hot staging test assembly has been installed on the test stand at Massey's, marking an important step in our readiness for future tests. As SpaceX takes its ambitious steps towards advancing its Starship program, the focus has shifted to the development of a new interstage design to facilitate hot staging. Thanks to the Ring Watchers, fellow enthusiasts of the Starship project, we've gained valuable insights into the new components that'll be utilized in this crucial process. It's set to undergo rigorous evaluation to ensure it can withstand the aerodynamic forces experienced during actual flight. The new interstage comprises three main components, each contributing to the structural integrity and overall effectiveness of the hot staging process. The bottom barrel section was originally the forward dome section of Booster 11, repurposed to serve as a test article for this particular stage. The decision to repurpose this section was likely made back in January of the same year, and it eventually underwent additional work before being moved to Tent 1 on July 6th. Extra stringers were added to this section, although it's important to note that these additional reinforcements are likely specific to the test article, as they may not be relevant to the actual staging process. Notably, two hot staging vent rings had been observed before the rollout of the current article. The first sighting occurred on May 25th, with a revised design being spotted on July 20th. The vertical supports of the vent ring are equipped with triangular stringers on the inside, providing critical support to the ring while helping to direct the exhaust gases outward. Furthermore, diagonal bracing in strategic areas aids in supporting torsion forces, enhancing the overall stability of the vent ring. The middle section of the interstage also features a large hoop stiffener, reinforced by a welded band on the inside, further bolstering its strength. Additionally, various locations on the interstage incorporate doubler plating, effectively increasing the thickness of the steel to enhance its durability. Regarding the attachment, it appears that the staging clamps will be utilized, given that the housings for these clamps were developed on the booster forward. Currently, the sections are only chained together, as a complete clamping system may not be necessary for the testing phase. Moving to the top section, it consists of the old leg skirt from ship 26.1. Several months ago, this leg skirt was removed from the test tank and sent back to the production site to undergo further enhancements, primarily involving the addition of more stringers. This reinforcement process is akin to the approach taken with the booster forward section, wherein a similar leg skirt was utilized during the interstage testing with Booster 6 towards the end of 2022. The application of pressure from the ship connection ensures that the interstage receives accurate testing and validation. The success of the hot staging test is of paramount importance, as it signifies a significant milestone in SpaceX's mission to revolutionize space travel. With hope and anticipation, we await the positive outcome of the tests and eagerly anticipate the potential integration of this new interstage design with Booster 9 in the not-too-distant future. As many of you are already aware, Mr. Musk has proposed a groundbreaking approach for the Starship launch, one that's both innovative and reminiscent of earlier Soviet and Russian space endeavors. The technique in question is called hot staging, a method that has, in fact, been utilized for several decades by the Soviets and Russians. For those unfamiliar, hot staging involves igniting the engines on one stage while it's still firmly attached to its lower stage. Now, what makes this approach so compelling and potentially transformative for the future of space travel? Imagine the possibilities this opens up for future space missions. With an increased payload capacity, we can envision larger satellites, more scientific instruments, or additional supplies for long-duration missions to distant celestial bodies. As we stand on the precipice of greatness, we must not forget the rigorous checklist that lies ahead. Booster 9 is set to undergo static fire testing, a critical step to ensure its readiness. But that's not all. We look forward to witnessing the majestic sight of Booster 9 and Ship 25 joined together in a full-stack configuration. This momentous union signifies the synergy of engineering and innovation that's brought us this far. Yet, before the grand spectacle of the launch, there is a final rehearsal, the full wet dress rehearsal, that'll put our team's expertise and coordination to the ultimate test. But worry not, for we've received the green light from the FAA, whose trust in our capabilities is a testament to our commitment to safety and excellence. As our excitement builds, we must acknowledge the challenges that lie ahead. The recent delay in moving Ship 25, still stationed on Pad B with flaps open and the OD attached, is a reminder of the unpredictable nature of space exploration. However, our resolve remains unwavering, and we are confident that we'll overcome the setback with determination and perseverance. So, my fellow space enthusiasts, as the countdown to the 2-hour-long closure begins, let us remember that every journey to the stars is filled with twists and turns. But with a firm belief in our abilities and a collective passion for exploration, there is no challenge too great. Together, we'll make history with Booster 9 and Ship 25, and soon enough, the resounding roar of the engines will echo across the cosmos as we embark on the extraordinary Starship Flight 2. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.